and get started this evening. For those of you that don't know me, my name is Jessica Madsen, and I'm the principal here at Elm Street School. So I have the pleasure of hanging out with some of the most outstanding students, including the ones that we have sitting up here tonight. You guys look great, and you're all together for the first time in a year. So let's celebrate that for sure. Without masks, yes, that's definitely something to be celebrated as well. All right, well, I just want to say welcome to our grade 6 graduates, our families, friends, and to the Elm Street School staff who joined us this evening. Sixth graders, tonight we celebrate one big step towards your future self. Life, you will find, is full of steps. Some are big, some are small, but all are leading you towards your future self and all that you will accomplish in the years ahead. As you prepare for this next chapter, I want to take a moment to congratulate you on all that you've accomplished here. And although you've completed your time as a Wildcat, your work is not yet completed, as you will soon begin the next chapter when you enter the halls of Whittier Middle School as seventh graders this September. Since my time here at ESS, the one word I've always heard from every person in our school and even in the town when describing your class was special. That you guys held a special place in the hearts of all your teachers, past and present, and that you've always held a special bond with each other and with our school. I want you to know that after 3 years here, I couldn't agree more. You guys are special. You're fun. You're a team. You're different. You're accepting. You take on hard challenges. And most importantly, I want you to know you're ready. You are ready for this next chapter in your lives. You've done the work. You've learned from some mistakes. You've supported each other. You've challenged each other to be your best every day. And you've prepared yourselves for the challenges that will lie ahead. As you move on, I encourage you to stay true to all the things that have made this class so special. Stay a team. And continue to encourage each other to do your best and to be your best. While things will certainly change next year as you welcome new classmates from our surrounding communities, I encourage you to show them the Wildcat way as you all become Midnights together. Show them how you care for each other and just how special you all are. Never forget where you came from as you head toward the person you strive to become. Lastly, if I can give you one piece of advice as someone who spent 15 years in middle school, only two of my own, and then 12 as a teacher, I encourage you to take advantage of every and each opportunity that comes your way to try something new. Middle school is an incredible place to take new risks, try something new, make new friends, step out of your comfort zone as you discover more about yourself and where you fit in. Whether it's guitar club, civil rights, geek squad, chorus, band, or even a sport you've never played before, dive in, try something new, and stick with the things you love. Being involved and being part of your school community in fun and new ways will be the greatest gift you can give to yourself in the years ahead. As you sit here today, do me a favor, set one goal for yourself. Try something new next year. Get involved, share who you are, because who you are is pretty awesome. And no matter where you go, remember this one thing. Once a Wildcat, always a Wildcat. All right, everybody. At this time, we are gonna start with our awards. So we have Mrs. Young coming up to present the Art Award.
So this is awarded by Miss Kennedy, and so the first one is being presented to Sky Lauren Diamond for her exceptional skills and dedication in art class. And then our second one is being awarded to Kalia Terrio again for her dedication in art class. I'd like to invite Mrs. Jenkins, our Dean of Students, to come up and give the PE award.
So I have to start by giving Mr. Rose a hard time. He is here this evening with us, but I get the pleasure of giving the ESS Phys Ed Award. So, for your outstanding skill and effort in PE, and I'm going to ask these students to come up because your parents may like have a picture of you. So, I'd like to start with Lucas Barrel. And Addison Gravel. And next up to give the music award is Ms. Terrio.
All right, this is an award that's given by Mr. Gagnon. And the first person that's getting this is Ireland Smith for outstanding participation in music at Elm Street School. If I gotta speak in a microphone, you're gonna walk out here. And up next we have Jax Hawks Cornwall for participation in music of Finn. And up next, we have the Principal's Award, awarded by Mrs. Mattson.
Alrighty. For the Principal's Award, this is an award that's given to a student who demonstrates leadership at Elm Street School. And here's the thing with leaders. Sometimes it's obvious, you walk in the room and you know right away who the leader is. But other times, it's not so clear. You see, leadership isn't always defined as the individual who commands the most attention in the room. It's actually the person who's the greatest influence on a group and whom others seek the respect of. When I think about the person that I chose for my leadership award, the following quote from Raceford Alexander comes to mind. "Leader, I learned, is a title that belongs to everyone who dares to claim it. It's not the power of your voice, but the power of your heart, the spirit of your mind, and the strength of your will that will determine where you lead yourself and others to go." For me, this award is going to a student who displays a quiet strength. He is respected and admired by his classmates, and he uses his influence to bring others up. He makes his peers feel valued, listened to, and cared about. He even stepped outside his comfort zone this year and took on the challenge of being our Elm Street School Wildcat. He's a positive role model, he's willing to work hard, and he has this quiet strength that I know will carry him far in life. My award goes to Nicholas Sprague. All right, and next up is the Citizenship Award from Mrs. Jenkins.
Citizenship Award is meant to recognize a student who possesses strength of character, gives back to the school community, follows school rules, and treats others with respect. In addition, the student actively participates in learning and has a positive attitude towards school, classmates, and the community. When I was asked to choose a student who meets this criteria, this young woman immediately came to mind. She is a kind and caring individual, yet she sure isn't afraid to stand up for her beliefs. She encompasses the qualities of a model citizen by treating her peers and adults with respect each and every day. She gives 110% in all that she does, both in school and outside of school. And her positive attitude and growth mindset will take her far in life. I had the privilege of teaching this student when she was a third grader, and have seen her give back to the ESS community in a variety of ways, most recently serving as our Cohort A Wildcat mascot. This student possesses each of the qualities that make her a well-rounded citizen. It is an honor to announce that the recipient of the Citizenship Award for the 2021 school year is Olivia Bunyan. Congratulations, I'm so proud of you and all that you have accomplished. Mrs. Madsen will now present the President's Award for Academic Excellence.
Every year we are asked to present presidential awards for educational excellence and for educational achievement. So the Award for Educational Excellence recognizes those students that have demonstrated academic excellence within their classroom. Students earning this award also demonstrate academic success traits such as high motivation, initiative, integrity, intellectual depth, leadership qualities, and/or exceptional judgment. So we have a number of students who have qualified for this award, so when I call your name, if you would come down and get your award from Mrs. Young. First up, I want to congratulate KK Terrio. Olivia Snowman. Molly Stoll. Chloe McGoffna. Peyton Rose. And Ireland Smith. Mrs. Jenkins will present the President's Award for Academic Achievement.
This award recognizes students that show outstanding educational growth, improvement, commitment, or intellectual development, often in one or more academic content areas. These students show tremendous growth, perseverance, and resiliency. I'm proud to announce Adeline Bryant. Nick Sprague. Lexi Morse. Lucas Verrill. And Olivia Bunye. And I have one more, Macy Harris. And now Mrs. Young will present the American Citizenship Award.
This award is given for outstanding leadership, school spirit, respectful behavior towards others, and volunteer work in the school and community. So we looked at a group of students who have spent some time doing volunteer work through the Girl Scouts. They went to the state to advocate for a bill, and so we wanted to recognize their actions in citizenship. So the first one is Adeline Bryant. Sky Lauren Diamond. Molly Stoll. And Ireland Smith. We start to do individual recognitions. So Ms. Terrio and I will alternate and tell you a little bit about our students.
All right. So I'm going to explain a little bit and keep it very brief. It's hot. I'm emotional. I'm a sixth grader up there, so I get it. First off is Caden Bonifant. You brought a sense of humor to our classroom as we never truly knew what you were going to say next. From your funny choice of reading material to your creativity to your funny side comments, you never shy away from being who you are.
Next is Jacob LaLiberty. When I think about Jacob LaLiberty, the first thing that comes to mind is his incredible artistic talent. His drawings are so amazing that when he puts them in the recycle bin at the end of class, kids want to take them out because they can't stand to think that it's just going in the trash. Jacob loves being with his peers and looks forward to reading classes with Ms. Terrio. We are excited for your future. Congratulations, Jacob.
Next, I have Adeline Bryant. Addie, you brought your feisty go-getter attitude to our classroom and into everything you do. You have a kind and generous heart, and you will never let anything get in the way of your heart's desires.
Next is Caden Albison. Caden keeps me laughing. It's his little comments here or there that can get us going. I have a feeling he's always been this way. He certainly showed that spirit in the pictures of him from second grade that Miss Harvey sent me, where I saw the giant grins and goofy faces. He's a friend to everyone and has leadership qualities that encourage others to follow his ideas. Use that power wisely, my friend. Congratulations, Kate. Next is Jacob
Alright, I have Olivia Bunye. You brought a sense of kindness and excitement into our classroom. I should have kept a box of tissues designated for you alone in our library. You do truly exemplify what it means to be an ESS Wildcat.
Next is Wesley Karen. Wesley is one in the class who probably dislikes our new desks the most. If you haven't seen them, they have an open shelf instead of a traditional box shape to put things in. Because of the open shelf, I can scoot down just a little and see that he most likely has an amulet book in his hands, distracting him from the math or social studies lesson. He has discovered a new love for books. For that, I am proud. I wish you hours and hours of reading this summer. Congratulations, Wesley.
I have Josh Cook. You brought a sense of competition to our classroom. You were always the one to encourage a friendly competition at recess, welcoming anyone that wanted to join.
Macy Harris. Macy has taught me about popular culture this year. She fills us in on YouTubers and TikTokers, what songs are in, what things are not. I try to keep up, but more likely I'm shaking my head and acting like I know what she's talking about. She strives to do her best on assignments and tests. She cares about making growth and doing well. Never stop being yourself and enjoy the new relationships that you will make in middle school. Congratulations.
All right, Aiden Franzen, you brought your love of technology to our classroom and didn't mind being the official technology helper for Ms. T this year. I do need one every year, and he was it. I always have one student each year that is willing to dig into any technology I have before I send out that tech help email. You were it, kiddo. Thank you.
Jax Hawks Cornwall. Jax is excellent at sending messages with his eyes. Masks caused everyone to be a little more dramatic with their facial expressions, and Jax has this down. Every once in a while, he'll get a sneaky little look on his face, and I know something clever is about to be said. He is so full of potential, and I look forward to watching it be tapped over the next several years. Dream big, and congratulations, Jax.
All right, Connor Furbush. You brought a sense of curiosity as well to our classroom. Coming into a new school is so difficult, but you were never shy about showing us who you are and keeping us on our toes about what silliness you would come out with next and leaving us speechless.
Brian King.
Brian has been a longtime student of Elm Street School. He was not with us in person this year, but we are grateful that we can still call him a Wildcat. We wish you the best as you head to the middle school next year. Enjoy all of the opportunities that they have there. Congratulations, Brian.
And gravel. Addie G, that's what I called her all year. You bring a sense of calm and quiet to our classroom. You have a calming presence about you, always listening and always curious, learning so much about the world around you and sharing your wisdom with us all. And she was also the ESS Physical Education Award recipient for outstanding skill and effort in PE.
Landon Levesque. Landon is a kind, respectful, quiet learner. He works hard and accomplishes what he puts his mind to. He does have a pretty funny side, too. On one of the first days of school, he was so annoyed that his glasses kept fogging up while wearing his mask. He grabbed the tape roll, and the next time I turned around, he had tape all over his face, mask, and glasses. He came up with a way to stop the fog, but I can't believe that he found it to be comfortable that way. I call that tenacity. Don't lose that quality. Congratulations, Lance.
Kaylin Henson. Kaylin, you bring a sense of resiliency to our classroom. You add humor, your beautiful writing that you are always willing to share, and your strength to each and every one of us.
The next one is Dallas Billings. And since this student has been in the VL5 program, I asked his fifth grade teacher, Miss Merrill, for some words. She said, Dallas Billings is such a kind, compassionate person. He is always willing to help his friends, his peers, or anyone that needs it. He stands up for what is right and goes above and beyond when it comes to being safe, respectful, and responsible. He pushes himself to always do his best and to be his best. Congratulations, Dallas.
Ziana Hunt, you bring a sense of artistic expression to our classroom. You think more deeply about the world around you and show this vividly through your art and kindness and writing with everyone.
Sky Loring Diamond. Sky is one of my class artists. I think every paper she completes has a doodle of some sort. She is not only artistic, but is also passionate about the things that are important to her. At times I've wondered whether she's listening while her legs are propped up on her desk, but then she comes back and adds a thoughtful comment to the discussion. I wish you much joy and peace as you move forward in your journey. Congratulations, Scott.
Gavin Lewis, you bring a sense of smallness when considering the universe as a whole to our classroom. I've never met a sixth grader who knew more about space and science than you. Keep sharing that and keep growing that knowledge. We'll all need it.
Alexiana Morse. I have a class full of hard workers, and Lexi is one of them. She wants to learn and do her best. She doesn't hesitate to send an email for clarification when she doesn't understand something. She attends school every day with a positive attitude. She loves talking about her family and the routines they have in their home. I know her brothers will miss seeing her on the playground every day as the classes pass, but you are ready to move on. Take advantage of every opportunity. Congratulations, Lexi.
Abel Mador. You bring a sense of humor as well to our classroom. You have a silliness and kindness about you, and you have a very loud personality that we all appreciate. You've learned a great deal about yourself this year. You have an army of people here at ESS that are going to miss you greatly.
Wyatt Nugent. Some students keep me on my toes, and Wyatt is one of them. He's like this little bundle of energy. He can be on one side of the playground, then I turn around and he's on the other side. He's full of ideas and passion. Wyatt is so ready to leave the elementary school world and head off to middle school. My words of wisdom are to persevere, try new things, and find good friends. I have no doubt in my mind that you will thrive. Congratulations, Wyatt.
Chloe McGoffna, you provided our classroom with a sense of connection. You are friends with all, and you help make us all feel like a family. And your excitement for math will always, and sometimes begrudgingly, be infectious.
Connor Omi. Connor is a student who always has something to add to the conversation. He thrives in an environment of being surrounded by his peers. He has a great sense of humor and is kind to everyone. We hear a lot about his family during morning meetings. It sounds like there is never a dull moment for the Omi boys. You have a big heart. Keep working hard to accomplish your goals. Congratulations, Connor.
Caleb Pinkham, you brought a sense of empathy to our classroom. You care about the people around you and the world around you, and you show it in so many ways throughout the day. You take great care of ESS and all of us. You also brought that silly sense of humor we all appreciate.
Autumn Purrington. When I met Autumn, one of her first questions was whether or not I remembered her brother. Of course I did, because every student holds a place in my heart. For Autumn, it was important that she establish her own identity instead of whatever she thought I might have as a first impression of her. Don't worry, Autumn, you have left your own impression. You're passionate, strong-willed, and a good friend. You care about your dearest friends, and they care about you. Continue in your journey. Congratulations, Autumn.
Caden Roush. You brought a ray of sunshine to our classroom during a year that truly needed it. I don't remember one time this year that you were in a bad mood. You genuinely care about everyone and the world around you, and you make sure that people are having fun. Keep that up.
Peyton Rose. Peyton is one of the hardest working students I've taught in sixth grade. She craves understanding and wants to grow in her knowledge. She dreams big about her future and thinks about the steps it will take to achieve her goals. I encourage you to continue to overcome any challenges that might get in your way. Keep persevering. Congratulations, Peyton.
Olivia Snowman. You bring a feeling of pause to our classroom. You share your open mind, creative nature, and work ethic to the world around you. And it allows us to think of the ways that we can be like this as well. You help people become their best selves. Don't lose that.
Ireland Smith. Ireland is my news reporter. She is aware of what's going on in the world and thinks about how it applies to our lives. She takes in historical events and thinks about the lessons we can learn from them. She knows that knowledge is power and that hard work will pay off in the end. She is a reader, writer, and mathematician. On top of that comes her athletic ability. You will go places. Congratulations, Ireland.
Molly Stowell. You bring a sense of kindness and compassion to our room. You have a peaceful nature about you, and you give 110% of yourself to everything you do. You make people feel seen, heard, and loved. This is a gift.
Nicholas Sprague. I've been fascinated watching Nick this year. He is a quiet leader amongst his peers. Other students are drawn to him and his personality. People want to be friends with Nick. I personally think it's a very good choice. He's a hard worker. He never gives up on learning, even when the concepts seem impossible. His persistence to accomplish things is amazing. For example, he has completed every single phys ed seesaw activity this year, and his PACER test showed that determination. So keep up the good work, and congratulations, Nick.
but certainly not least with that bright personality. Lucas Verrill, you brought many laughs to our classroom intentionally and often unintentionally. He has the kind of sense of humor that he can say something and you laugh even if he doesn't. You are a true friend to all and make sure that everyone is having fun. Along with Josh, you were always the one encouraging a friendly competition at recess, and you usually won.
Kaylee Aterio. Kaylee had joined us at the beginning of the year. I felt like I already knew her a little bit from stories, but I had no idea there was so much talent in this child. Yes, she excels in academics, but her real talent? Maybe acting and storytelling. The number of times I opened random seesaw videos and was treated to puppet shows or plays I couldn't possibly count. My favorite was the video Time Capsule. She reviewed the many, many uses of masks. I know I've been caught wearing mine as a chin diaper many times on the playground. Never lose your imagination. Congratulations, Kalia. Spencer Yonis. Spencer is a student with very strong opinions and thoughts about many topics in the world. He doesn't hesitate too much to advocate for his beliefs or point of view. If he doesn't agree, he'll question the why. Don't lose this sense of passion. Keep asking the why so that you can learn from others and perhaps adapt your way of thinking or perhaps be more solid in your opinion. I wish you the best, Spencer. Congratulations. Traditions that we have here at Elm Street School is that all of the students receive a flower, but it is not for them. They take their flower and they think about somebody that's made an impression on them throughout their journey in education. This could be family members, siblings, friends, teachers. So they have been thinking about this. So we're going to give a minute to get the flowers passed out, and then they will break for a moment and get them passed out.
All right, sixth graders, go ahead and give those roses. Let's give one last round of applause for the class of 2027. All right, that brings us to the end of our formal ceremony here this afternoon, this evening. It's hot. We do have water and popsicles over there under that station over there for students. For the adults, there's plenty of water there. We do have a slideshow that the teachers put together to kind of capture their year here. We are going to do two showings, so we'll do one at 7:15 and then one at 7:30, and that's up in the Elm Street School Gymnasium. So hopefully you guys can get up there and catch that. The lawn games are set up. Encourage you to hang out and have some fun, and then we'll see you for the slideshow. Thanks for coming, everybody.